Hello all. In this video, we are going to see about forging, what is forging, classifications of forging and their advantages and disadvantages. First, let's have a look into what is forging. Forging is a forming process. It's a type of forming process in which the material is heated above the recrystallization temperature, and after reaching the recrystallization temperature, it is compressed with the help of hammers or other forging tools. So it can be done either manually or with the help of machines. If the forging is done with the help of manual, it is called as smith forging, or if it is done with the help of machines, it is called as power forging. Now let's have a look into what is forging in detail. Forging is a manufacturing process involving the shape of metal using localized compressive forces. The blows are delivered with a hammer. If the blows are delivered with a hammer, it is called as manual smith forging or manual forging. And if it is done with a machine, it is called as power forging. The forging has several advantages. The first one is closer dimensional accuracies are achieved with the help of this forging. Surface finish will be better. There is no wastage of metals. So these are some of the advantages of the forging process. Now let's look into the classifications of forging. So the forging, it is broadly classified into four types. One is open die forging, closed die forging, impression die forging and flashless forging. First one is open die forging. So this forging, open die forging, usually it is of smith forging type, that is manual forging type. And the in this, the workpiece is compressed between two plate ends. There is no constraint to the material flow in this direction. Upsetting is an open die forging in which billet is subjected to lateral flow by the flat die under punch. So the punch, usually it is given with the help of a hammer, because since it is a manual type or a smith forging type, the advantages of the open die forging are it can be done easily, it doesn't require any skilled labors, and the it is a very simple process. Forged components exhibit high strength. And some other disadvantages of this process are low production rate. So the component, it takes more time to complete a component. Skilled operators are required for manipulation of workpiece, and machining to the final is necessary, and there is a wastage of material. And the next one is about impression die forging. In impression die forging, both die and punch have impressions shapes which are imparted onto the other workpiece. There is no more constrained flow in this process. Moreover, excess metal flows out of the cavity forming flash. So here in this process, the excess metal is coming out as a flash. So if you look into the advantages of these process are, it is suitable for small and medium sized components, produces dimensionally accurate things, good surface finish can be obtained. And the disadvantages are, it is not suitable for all large sized components, and initial die cost is more compared to that of other forgings. And the next one is about flashless forging. So in this, the workpiece is totally constrained to move within die cavity, no excess material, hence no flash is formed. Flashless forging involves a high level of accuracy. Design and of a shape of die cavity, finished product are very much important, as the metals doesn't come out. So the die and of cavity should be of such a way that the material does not comes out, and it cannot come out also. Some of the advantages of the flashless components are, it is suitable for large components, and the major disadvantage of all the forging processes, it is not suitable to produce large number of components at the same time. And the next one is about closer die forging. It is a closer die forging process in which the volume, work volume of the cavity is equal to the die cavity volume, whereas no allowance for flash, and excess material or inadequate material will lead to a defective part. So it should be equal to the workpiece volume should be equal to the die cavity volume, so that it produces a perfect part while doing the forging operation. If the billet size is less than the underfilling, also underfilling takes place. Oversized billet, it damages the die or damage to the press. So this is a pictorial representation of a open die forging and closed die forging. So here in this diagram you can observe that in a open die forging there is no cavity and the material can flow in any direction, and with here the compression is given with the help of a hammer. But in case of a closed die forging, you can see a cavity over here, over which only in that cavity the material can flow. So this is about the classifications of forging. Thank you.